So here we are, ready to go racing for one final time this year. Another season of victories, controversies and rivalries lies in our wake. And just one challenge remains here in the United Arab Emirates on a circuit that made its spectacular debut back in 2009. Welcome to the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. We have 21 corners here at Yas Marina Circuit, with 10 to the right and 11 to the left, for a total lap distance of 3.4 miles. Two long straights open up some passing opportunities into the chicanes, and we can expect average lap speeds of around 123 miles per hour. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Davidson. They've had a fantastic campaign. It's been a wonderful year, and they come into this weekend's Grand Prix as a fully deserving champion.
It really is well deserved. I wouldn't say it's been a faultless title challenge, but certainly one that has been consistent and well managed. Here's hoping they let off a bit of steam today and give us an exciting race.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Davidson lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Raikkonen, Fernando Alonso, and Hülkenberg, Sainz, Leclerc, Perez, and Lewis Hamilton, Ocon, Magnussen, Sebastian Vettel, and Sorokin, Hartley, Gasly, Marcus Ericsson, and Lance Stroll, Grosjean, and Daniel Ricciardo rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
This is the final race of the season. Go out there and enjoy it. Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. No threat of rain for the time being, conditions looking good. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. Well done, mate. Nice start. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the ultrasofts. Okay, we're hitting the rated limits on the MGU-H. The power unit is going to be more prone to overheating. Our data shows the tyres are okay right now. We anticipate good levels of grip for the next few laps at least. The energy store is getting worn, reducing our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. Box, box. We're coming in this lap. Box now, please. Box this lap. All right, we're seeing a loss of power from the turbocharger now. Loss of power on the turbo. Go, go, go. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Fernando's in for his stop. Great work. That's a new fastest lap for the race. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. The gap to the car behind is 41.7 seconds. We're leading our teammate by 44.8 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. The gap behind us is 47.9 seconds. You're increasing the gap to the car behind by a few seconds per lap. Keep this up. Okay, the incident has been cleared. Let's get back up to racing speed. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
What a fantastic Grand Prix that was, and an excellent win for McLaren. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
Here come our winning drivers then, out onto the podium at the end of a thrilling Grand Prix. The drama and excitement are over, and it's time to let it all sink in. Congratulations to our top three today. Davidson increases their championship lead. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was